Hey, this is Falcon 5's development video number 2. This video showcases what I've been working on for the past month for my game, pixel perfect collision detection with rectangles and triangular slopes. First, I have not been able to work on my game as much as I would have liked. This probably would have gotten done in half a month provided I had enough spare time, but it took a whole month, and that's just working on my spare time. Oh well. So either way, why would I want to spend a whole bunch of time programming functionality into my game for sloped platforms? Simply put, sloped platforms add a much-needed flavor to levels in 2D platformers. Being able to change up the terrain that the player is traversing throughout the entire game enables me to keep the levels interesting to traverse for the player. Levels built simply with cubes get old quickly. Note one of the many differences between Super Mario Bros. And Super Mario Bros. 3. While both games are fun, Super Mario Bros. 3 is undoubtedly more fun than Super Mario Bros., and part of this has to do with the level design. Super Mario Bros. Is built entirely with 16 by 16 pixel cubes. Super Mario Bros. 3 has cubes, 22.5 degree angle slopes, 45 degree angle slopes, and 67.5 degree angle slopes. For example, you can play 10 levels of Super Mario Bros. And you will start feeling as if you've seen what the game has to offer in terms of level design. However, with Super Mario Bros. 3, by 30 levels in, one still feels that there is still more to see. Seeing as I want my game to have around 50 levels, not to mention a level editor for players to create and play their own levels, it is important for there to be a variance in level terrain. I placed it high on my priority list to have the same angles found in Super Mario Bros. 3, because with these angles, I can create a variety of terrain types. You can have flat plains, sharp angular cliffs, smooth hills, and many other terrains. It's pretty much up to the level designer as to what the level is going to be. There will be nearly no limits on creativity as far as terrain goes. With these angled tiles, one can construct a very convincing looking circle, which demonstrates how versatile these three angles combined with cubes can be. There is still a bit more tweaking to be done with my collision detection system, but I'm confident that soon I will be able to start on character movement, gravity, and friction. Updates will go onto my website, http://sites.google.com/site/falcon5dev/. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.